и увидеть, и услышать, увидеть презентацию, услышать выступающего, это будет на английском. Так что можно запускать. Представитель компании Dow Chemical здесь. Сейчас мы попробуем это все услышать.
Окей. Okay, do you hear me? It's okay?
Yes. Okay.
Okay. So good morning, everyone. First, I would like to apologize for not being in person at your conference. As you, of course, know, last Friday we had in France dramatic events, and so we decided to limit traveling. So this is why I am not here today. I will give my presentation so very quickly. My colleague Vassili Demidov is in the room, so of course, if you have also some questions afterward, you will be able to speak with me. Okay, so let's start. I am working at Dow for a couple of years. I was in the technical service before, moving to sales recently, and specialist in the nutrition application. For Dow, this is the oil exchange company, so we have a global presence. As you can see on this map for oil exchange, we have manufacturing facility in US, in Europe. Chile is the largest plant in the world for manufacturing oil exchange resin. And also we have a presence in Asia, with again a plant in Shanghai. On top of that, we are not serving only the oil exchange markets, but also the membrane. So we have, and I just wanted to highlight that we are producing also membranes, so we just also do this nanofiltration in the US. At Dow, even if this technology is well known for years and years, so it was used in water treatment, so it's more than 50 years technology, we are still innovating, and our portfolio today is based on the well-known Endorlite family product that everybody knows, but also the Dorex, because as you know, we were merging between Dow and Romanas in 2009. So today, we are number one on that. And again, the key word for Dow is reliability, value, but also innovation. So I will, based on my presentation, it's really based on some work that's worked on in our research team in US. And so I will start with that. Just the basics for the separations and strategies. In this industry, it's very easy. So it's, you have a mixture with molecules and impurities. This feed is going through the bed of resin, the pack bed. And at the exit, you have all the impurities. So it could be minerals, color, unreacted sugars when we are talking about fermentation, nitrogen compounds, and also proteins. And the value products will be carbohydrates, organic acids, or amino acids. We will focus here on sugars and organic acids, so that you will see that in the next next slide. So as you remember, so the iodation is a nice picture of a uniform cell iodation resin. It was used a lot before in water treatment. But today, in fact, this technology is what we use in many different industries. So not only the food industries, but also petrochemical, industrial processes, hydrometallurgy, healthcare. So there is many applications of this technology today. If we are looking to the segment of interest and for this conference, if we are looking to this cornstarch transformation layout, we can see that at many places in this process there is ion exchange technology. So we can find resin at the decolorization step here. We have resin for the glucose dehydration step, of course, leading to liquid dextrose. Again, a resin, if you want to make HSCR, so chromatographic enrichment, it's a chromatographic resin. And we are also from the fructose side, so for 55 fructose or 42 fructose syrup, we also have iodexane step. In this segment, we have two routes for producing all these products, so meaning amino acids or organic acids. The first one is more the biochemical route, and it's mainly derived from the fermentation. So we are starting from the starch, and after that, you have here, it's just an overview of all the pathway when we are talking about the biochemical route. And in parallel to that, we can have the chemical route. So in this route, again, starting from the starch, see here that it's mainly acidic treatment, like here. It's mainly some chemical reactions, or could be a reduction with the help of a catalyst, could be oxidation, hydrogenation, for instance, for making sorbitol out of glucose. So this is these two slides. It's really to have the overview where we will see resin for making amino acid or organic acid. So in summary, using ion exchange, this picture is describing. So you start upstream with the raw material, could be sugars, biomass, starches. So you have this upstream hydrolysis or fermentation, enzymatic transformation. After that, we have the downstream processing with ion exchange. So again, as I already showed you, we will find it for demineralization of the stream, decolorization of chromatography. At the end of that, we have the final product. Could be, and it's a large segment today, this industry, caloric sweeteners. Out of that, we have derivatives from sweeteners. Organic acid is more and more important also. And polymer and biopolymers also out of organic acid. So today, we can find polyelective, we can find this type of product on the market. Let's move to the second part of my presentation, and it's an update from our research team. So we have developed and we have measured, in fact, the separation performance. So it was based on the very well-known pulse testing. So it means the aim of this work was really to have a full overview, especially for organic acid and sugars, to establish a tool for predicting the separation. So it was made again on the first test, so very very simple. It was injections of many products, so many organic acids for the first part, having the retention time, and based on that to have a prediction of the separation. So out of that, we obtain this type of matrix. So it's a quite a busy slide with many information. But just simply, you see that on the right side of the slide, it's the R is the resolution. So resolution meaning here, where when you have less than 0.2, the separation between two compounds is very poor. Moving to 0.5, you start to have, and especially at the industrial scale, this type of separation would be could be useful at the industrial scale for starting of the separation. Equal 1, of course, the perfect. So you have two peaks, your two compounds are fully separated. And when you are moving to R, superior to 1, it's somewhere too much because you don't need that again at the industrial scale. So based on this matrix, have been able to have this type of overlay chromatogram. So here you see acid-acid separation. So it's, for instance, application where you are producing citric acid from glucose, for instance. So you see the separation between the three different organic acids, like succinic or citric, out of glucose. So it was a prediction just with the retention time by using the pulse test. Here, using again this overlay chromatogram, so we see more organic acids, and again separation, so we see just on one chromatogram what will be the separation between these two compounds. And out of that, so this is what we have established in the research team. It's a model, a modelization, to have a predicting tool for just anticipating the separation between the compounds. So this prediction tool is mainly based on the chemistry of the product. So it's based on the number of carboxylic acid groups, for instance, hydroxyl, degree of the separation, so number of double bonds in the molecule, overall molecular size, just for having its chromatography, for the having a size exclusion effect, and also on the functional group polarity. So here on this plot, you see it's the real, so the Q1 actually is the real resolution between two compounds, and in X is the prediction. So we see that, of course, the perfect fit between actual and predicted will be a straight line with a slope of 1. So we see that the dispersion is quite interesting, and we have a correlation R squared at 0.9, which is a good fitting between the prediction and the reality. So based on that, you see that here on the right side of the slide, by using the predicting tool, we can simulate and model size. If you have to do and to deal with this type of separation, we can have a prediction at the beginning for checking, okay, for this type of organic acid, it will be very difficult to have a nice separation. From prediction to reality, so here we see a selective removal of furfural and HNF, which is for some application an issue today to solve. So we see by using this tool that we can see a nice separation between a different type of organic acid and a nice separation as out of that HNF and furfural. So this is where we see that the prediction tool will be used before moving to the industrial scale. We did the same exercise with sugars. So here, it's a separation of oligosaccharides. So we have glucose, maltose, raffinose, and saccharose. So again, you see in one petroleum, the level of separation we can have. Here, we did that for HFCS, serum, fructose glucose, bioethanol, and sugar alcohols. So leading to the same type of matrix that we have seen before for the organic acid. So we have repeated the same first test exercise for having a prediction on separation among all these sugars and derivatives. In summary, at the Dow, in fact, we can help the industry for building up separation strategies. Knowing, and this is, I was just taking this small example, because we can see here that on a very, very common technology used, I mean chromatography, for instance, in SMD technology, we see that the chromatography, the resin cost, in fact, is very small. If you look just on the HFCS chromatome, for the cost of this step is only 0.09 cents for the resin, 0.84 just for water evaporation, and if you transfer that to the cost of that compared to the selling price of 1 kilo of HFCS, is again very very small. Just meaning that, I wanted to highlight that the contribution of the resin in this type of process is very helpful, but not but cost effective. And for us at our home, it's always about innovation. So we are not speaking only on developing new products, but we can also improving process design. And we have a global organization with a very well-structured TSMB structures, research, so we can really help this type of industry. I thank you very much for your attention. And I don't know how we can be, if we have some questions, or maybe Vassili can help with all the audience. So, thank you again.
Thank you, Laurent. Технология сработала, и мы смогли увидеть презентацию. Здесь вопросы. Мои комментарии, что презентация очень техническая, но если мы рассмотрели, первое, те списки продуктов, которые там показаны на количестве кислот, это как раз потенциальные ваши продукты для производства вот, на заводе блока перерабатывания. А второе, мы все стремимся производить не просто commodity, а продукты с высокой добавленной стоимостью, желательно в пищевом или фармацевтическом рынке. И обмен, который сейчас мы представим, он как раз позволит добиться вот таких вот показателей. То есть нужно очень внимательно относиться, потому что может быть гораздо более делать несколько сот тонн продуктов для фармацевтики или пищевого рынка, чем может быть 1000 тонн продуктов для ну там, животноводства. Поэтому нишево можно рассматривать, и обменные технологии, представленные компанией DAO, это, конечно же, очень-очень интересно. Особенно те списки продуктов, которые они представили, могут быть вашими потенциальными продуктами на заводах переработки зерна. Есть ли вопросы конкретные по технологии? Ну, если вопросов конкретных нет, то прошу общаться с Василием. По поводу конкретных обсуждений, конкретных процессов, надеюсь, что компания, конечно, помогает инструментам установок для заводов. И этим мы завершаем нашу первую сессию презентации. И хотел бы сделать несколько объявлений. Первая презентация конгресса будут все предоставлены по ссылке участникам вашего запроса в электронной почте на любые e-mail. Второе, есть несколько стаканов из молочной кислоты, из биопластика, если кому-то хочется образцы, тоже, пожалуйста, можете их разобрать. Есть образцы сухой борды, и я бы хотел еще позвать Владимира Данилова, если он здесь в зале. Да, у нас компания «Морган Биопродукт» представляет продукты биоэтанольного или биотопливного, я бы сказал, плана. Вот визитки, которые раньше были, вчера мы разыгрывали виски, они снова в эту коробку.